Now let's create a completely new zone list schedule. We are interested in how much paint we'll need in the central module and also what the heating costs will be. Open the Scheme Settings dialog again and click on the Create New button. The schedule name will be Zone List. Click OK. The new schedule appears in the list of available schedules. In the Criteria panel, select Zone as element type. In the Fields panel of the Zone parameter set, add the Zone category, Zone name, Zone number, and Wall surface area parameters to the schedule fields. Also, add the Area and Net Volume parameters from the General parameter set. You may rearrange the parameters in the Schedule fields list if you wish. We would also like the schedule to show the floor finish used in the rooms, but that parameter is not listed here. So let's click on Add Objects Parameters. From the Library, select the Zone Stamp object we used for the Zone categories. This is the Zone Stamp GSM object. List the available parameters by name and find the Floor Type String Type parameter among the available parameters. Select the Add button to add it to the list on the right. Click OK, and upon returning to the Scheme Settings dialog, the Floor Type parameter has been added to the Scheme fields. Move it upwards in the list, below the zone name. You may rearrange the parameters as shown on the screen. Alongside the parameters, we see little buttons. The first defines the sorting order. Let's click on the second button of the wall's surface area parameter so that a sum sign appears. This way, a grand total of this parameter will be calculated. Do the same with net volume and area parameters. Click OK to close the Scheme Settings dialog. The new schedule is automatically displayed on the screen and also added to the views in the project map. You can double-click it here to display it at any time later on. We can adjust the width of the columns in the schedule by pulling the small handles in the rule so that each text is fully visible.